Now we have one panel drawn, but if we come over here to the panel, we'll see that there's a bunch of more dialogue. He needs to whistle. Here, Spot whistles. Come on, boy, where are you hiding? So we're going to need more than one panel, more than one drawing to show that. And if we come back to the storyboard panel and we look at the script, you can see that we're going to need a lot of panels and a couple of different scenes. So I'm planning on cutting here to another scene after he walks a bit further and slumps. So for now, we're going to be adding some panels and then we'll add another scene. There are a few different ways to add a panel, and we'll start by selecting the panel that we're working on. And the first way, let's go up to the toolbar. And here is a storyboard toolbar with a bunch of different icons. The one we're looking for just says New Panel, and it looks like a sheet of paper or a panel with a plus sign on it. So I'm going to click on that, and down below, a new empty panel has appeared. And if you look at the naming, this is Scene 1, Panel 1 of 2, and Scene 1, Panel 2 of 2. So when it adds panels and scenes, there's a certain auto renumbering that can happen. In addition to that, you'll notice that the black rectangle around these two panels is going to indicate that it's all one scene made up of two different panels. Another way to add a panel is by coming up to the menu at the top, click on Storyboard, and then New, and then New Panel, or you can choose New Panel Before. So I'm going to click New Panel. All right, and it has appeared right there. Also, you could just press the letter P on your keyboard. That's a shortcut, and I'm going to press it now, and a new panel has appeared. Now, these new panels all have the same default layer setup, and they don't have any artwork on them. And so let me delete those, and then I will show you another way to add a panel. By the way, to delete these, I could just click on any one of them and come up here to press the delete key on the toolbar, or I can sort of drag across them so that two of them are selected, and also come up and press that red X. One more way you can add a panel is to right click with your mouse on the panel, and a little mini menu comes up and you can click New Panel from there. When you add an empty panel like this, it may be difficult to draw what's next because you don't have any reference to work from other than just looking at the panel before. So some of the ways to solve this are, first of all, you can take the background from the first panel, and if you click on the image part of that layer and then drag down to the layer tabs below and let go, it's essentially going to let you replace that background layer. So what it says is the layer called BG already exists down here, so you could choose to replace it or rename it. So I'm going to say replace. And when I do, you can see now that the background is in both images. Now for the character itself, you can just use the onion skin to help you keep track of where your character has been and where your character is going. So the onion skin is a very handy way of planning out your scene. Let me show you how to enable that. If you come up to your toolbar, you'll be looking for this icon that looks like a stack of pancakes with red on the side and an eyeball on top. If you want to see more of it, you can drag this handle and pull over until you can see the full toolbar. You can also grab by that handle, pick it up, and move it into a different place. Now, when I click on this, watch what happens. All right, now what I've done is, even though I'm in the second panel, I can see the pose from the first panel. So this artwork isn't actually here. It's just a guide image that will not print out and will not export in any way. It's just there for your own reference. Okay, I'm going to grab a brush, come over here to my tool properties, pick the brush that I like. I'm going to pick a color. In this case, I'm going to try something new. I'm going to press this blue color, and I want to just kind of block in where I want the character to be. So he's roughed out right now, and I know where I want him to be. I can add another layer to start to draw him in a little bit more. Now that I want to do more work on this figure, I can simply turn off that onion skin, because you can turn it on and turn it off anytime that you want to. So I've added a layer. Even though this is in blue, I'm going to click the light table button to dim that out. I'm going to choose my brush, click the one I want and the color that I want, and I'm just simply going to work on firming this up a little bit.